Gasoline direct injection, GDI, has been around for many years, and now the fuel delivery systems are growing even more complex, with some manufacturers equipping their engines with both direct and port fuel injection. By now, you may have already been presented with a vehicle exhibiting drivability complaints or DTCs related to fuel delivery on these systems. As you're most likely aware, proper gasoline direct injection operation is highly dependent not only on the engine-mounted high-pressure pump, but other items such as the integrity of the low-pressure in-tank fuel pump, volume control regulation, mechanical soundness of the cam lobes driving the high-pressure pump, and more. Hi, this is Scott Brown with another MotorAge Tech Tip brought to you by Hitachi Astemo. Hitachi Astemo supplies OEM high-pressure pumps to a majority of the fleet, which includes General Motors, Nissan Infiniti, Volkswagen Audi, and others. Their replacement service GDI high-pressure pumps performs like the same high-quality OEM pumps installed at the factory on hundreds of thousands of vehicles. To ensure performance, reliability, and durability are met, their high-pressure pumps are tested 100% to OEM standards. Recently, I was able to work with their engineering team to gather several helpful tips that you, as a service professional, can use when troubleshooting GDI systems. This video will include some great knowledge around high-pressure pump handling and service procedures that will help you deliver the highest quality service possible when working with these systems. I learned quite a bit while working with Hitachi Astemo, and I'm excited to bring you this information, so let's get started. It's becoming rare to see a new vehicle not equipped with GDI today, and when one arrives in your bay with a problem, possessing a deeper awareness of the high-pressure pump and the areas that can present challenges will go a long way in reaching a positive service experience. Issue number one, DTCs P0172 and or P0175, fuel system too rich. While high rail pressure could be the cause, it usually isn't, because the ECM monitors this closely and uses rail pressure value to arrive at injector on time. This could be caused by a crankcase that is saturated with fuel due to a leaking high-pressure fuel pump. Now, you should be aware that the lower chamber area is not a source of high-pressure fuel, but there is fuel in this chamber area, and a leaking shaft seal can occur due to several reasons. The first thing to be aware of in certain vehicle applications is that the spring-loaded plunger can be pulled out of the pump, and if this happens, the seal can be damaged. So when handling a pump, be sure to never pick it up by the spring section. The Hitachi Astemo pumps have specialized seals designed for long life and require specific tools to be used during assembly to ensure proper sealing integrity. If the plunger is pulled out of a pump, it will need to be replaced with a new pump. Issue number two, P0088, fuel pressure too high, or P0089, fuel pressure regulator performance. The ECM has tight control over how much pressure the high-pressure fuel pump can produce through a volume control regulation solenoid. But be aware, the pressure can only be reduced through the opening of the fuel injectors. This precise regulation is achieved through tight electrical control of the solenoid as shown in the scope pattern. This pattern shows the relationship between the high and low pressure periods dictated by the pump camshaft lobes and the volume control segments. GDI systems require accurate timing information so that the volume flow control valve can be controlled at the right time.
If the intake valve closes too early, excessive pressure will build up, which could lead to P0088 and P0089 issues. Or if the intake valve closes too late, then there is not enough pressure to build up, which could lead to P0087 issues.
Keep this in mind when addressing DTCs such as P0088 or P0089. If you have any timing-related DTCs, then these should be addressed before pursuing the high-pressure control issues. Additionally, if the supply voltage is inadequate or the driver within the ECM is damaged, pressure regulation will suffer. Utilizing an oscilloscope by measuring the control voltage, control signal amperage, and rail pressure sensor can tremendously help during analysis. Issue 3, P0087, fuel pressure too low. A worn camshaft lobe or follower could result in a low system pressure, but so could poor operation of the low pressure fuel pump. Poor lubrication can lead to premature failure of the high pressure camshaft lobes or follower assembly. Careful inspection of both areas should be performed when investigating a fuel delivery problem. More on that in a moment. Issue number 4, DTCs P0171 and P0174, fuel system too lean. Remember, the high pressure pump must be supplied with an adequate volume of fuel from the intake fuel pump. Validating the performance of the fuel supply system should be performed before condemning the high pressure pump. If your diagnosis leads you to replacing the high pressure pump, here are a few items to be aware of. As mentioned earlier, a close inspection of the camshaft lobes should be performed by hand rotating the engine in its normal run direction to inspect the lobes. Service information can provide details regarding specifications and how to measure the lobes. Additionally, the camshaft follower should be inspected for wear as well and replaced if needed. And be aware that you cannot install a pump when the drive lobe is on a lift point. You will need to rotate the engine in the normal run direction by hand to the low point on the camshaft, or you will damage the pump. The high pressure line is typically a one-time crush style fitting, so replacement is typically required. Check for service information for specific details. Now, the low pressure supply hose may require replacement as well. Their engineers have found that on some vehicles, the internals of the hose decay over time and can lead to a restricted high pressure pump inlet screen. Additionally, you may also notice a band on the low pressure hose like this one. This is indicative of a one-way check valve. In most cases, this hose can only be connected one way, but you may find a vehicle that the hose can be installed backwards, which can lead to a no start. Initial diagnosis. While following the manufacturer's diagnostic steps can help you arrive at a proper diagnosis, using a capable scan tool, the technician can make a few observations about system operation by observing the following high pressure PIDs: desired fuel rail pressure and actual fuel rail pressure. Additionally, some manufacturers also have a low pressure supply pressure transducer installed on the vehicle, so that PID can be used as well. From there, the technician will need to utilize their skill, expertise, and service information to arrive at a solid diagnosis. For more information about Hitachi Astemo, please visit hitachiastemo.com. I hope you found this video informative, and if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below, and thanks for watching.